welcome to our video on SEMA's syllabus change. And hi, and welcome to our video on SEMA's syllabus change. And this video will focus on the new exam patterns under the 2019-2020 syllabus, or the new syllabus, together with transition arrangements. So if you've completed the SEMA qualification up to a certain level, exactly what type of impact this is going to have on you under the new syllabus. So let's start off with exactly what the exam style is going to be with the new syllabus. And you've got good news. There is absolutely no change. You're still going to have an OTQ exam for every subject, and once you've completed that, at the end of each level, you've still got to attempt a case study examination. So the moment you complete your three OTQs for the operational level, that's E1, P1, F1, you've got the operational case study examination that you need to clear to move on to the next level. And the same trend continues at each level. So that's a bit of a relief that there is absolutely no change in terms of the examining approach. Well, exam dates. When is it that you can expect the new syllabus to take effect? Now, this is especially relevant to some of you, especially if you have been following certain subjects under the old syllabus and you want to complete them before the new syllabus kicks in. So expect it around the first, second week of November 2019, so get all of your OTQ exams done and dusted by the end of October. And the first case study examinations will be tested in February 2020. So the last chance for you to complete your case study examinations under the current syllabus will be November 2019. Finally, transition arrangements. So what if you have not been able to complete a particular level, or what if you have completed one or two subjects at a particular level? How does this have an impact on you moving into the new syllabus? Well, I'm going to try and explain to you using a very, well, simple example. But the good news to start off is that Every module or every subject that you complete under the old syllabus will directly gain credit under the new syllabus. That's the 2015 syllabus. Any examinations that you've completed will be recognized as a credit for you under the new syllabus, right? So for example, let me take P1 under the 2015 syllabus. If you've completed P1 and not done any other exams beyond that, under the 2019 syllabus, you will still gain credit for the P1 subject, meaning the new syllabus, your exam status will show that you have completed P1. So you will still need to attempt E1 and F1 and then do your operational case study and proceed with, of course, the rest of the SEMA qualification. Hopefully this video was helpful. And you can now put down a timeline as to exactly what you need to do prior to the new exams kicking in. Thank you.